situated there, or this facility is situated there. So you don't need to advertise differently, or you don't have to spend more for the your advertisement. So this is a good advantage of having your place in the medical hub. Plus the investigation facilities, imaging, you need pathological lab or diagnostic lab. So if you are in the vicinity of the labs, your facilities is, though your patient is getting benefited. Then the care from your clinic or hospital, it's our utmost thing. Basic facilities, because the patient are more debilitated and sufferers, so elevators, wheelchairs, trolleys, and your staff, then the chairs, then proper ventilation and adequate spacing. This is the very important thing. So because your all patients, they are dependent mostly time, they are vulnerable. So your furniture, your business plan, your mapping, your architecture should be clearly told when you are in the planning of your pain clinic. And this is the important thing. Then there is staff and service, they should be patient friendly. Name of the clinic should be clearly written, and there should be always suggestion box so that you can get proper feedbacks. Then price should be clearly mentioned in the chart or display board, whatever things, but the price consultation chart should be clearly mentioned with which time, when time, or what is the prices. There should be provision for cashless, credit and debit card payment, and there could be medical packages for the patient who are not insured, and then the economical packages you can offer, especially for the poor person and the senior citizens. Then the people. Third P is the people. People are the most important constituents. Staff members, marketing planner or PRO, and the patients. They are the three corners of the... Okay. So patients are the very important thing. They're mouth-to-mouth publicity tool. Then you can make the telephone calls. Then the front desk and reception is very important, because they are the person who deal with the patients. So consulting time, treatment option, fee, appointment, all these things, they are deal with the front desk people. So you have to train your front desk people or receptionist very close, because they are the first experience of your pain clinic with the patient. So this is a very important thing. Then promotions. What are different plans? If you have promotions, how can you promote your pain clinics? By the media marketing, or marketing among medical community, among the general population, and marketing inside of four pain clinics. So these are the four areas where you can market your pain clinic. How can you cover the media? By the newspaper and magazine, the television, FM radio, internet-based marketing, social networking site. Newspapers, you can publish your articles, interview with the consultants, with the real patient, stories, advertisements, press conferences, and coverage of the news items you can cover in the newspapers and magazines. Then the televisions, you can record it, or live show can be organized, so that like live show you can interact with the audience, and it is a very wider range, so that you can reach to the wider audience at a small time. Then internet-based marketing, web presence is nowadays is very important, because most of the patients, they search you, your services on the web and mobile. So advertisement, you can put your advertisement on various search engines, Google's and your local search engines, registration and web portals. It's a very common everywhere, every city has a different web portals. Then you can use the services of AdWords and search engine optimization. You can develop your applications. You can use the bulk SMS or bulk email services. Then the network marketing, which is one of the very cheapest source of the marketing. You don't have to invest much, but it is a very good source of the marketing. Facebook, LinkedIn, Twitter, Google Plus, WhatsApp. You can post your videos on the YouTube, and it is very cost effective. And especially it is very good for the newer persons who are in the market. And marketing among the medical community, how you will go to market yourself in the amongst the medical community, by the CME symposium, conferences, workshop, training and teaching courses, pain journals, medical association, forums and NGOs. So CME is that it can be organized a small talk awareness program by the different group of doctors. You can select the target audience, physicians, spine surgeons, oncologists. So these are the different groups you can target upon, and then you can target the physiotherapist and paramedical staffs. And that is very important, educate and creating awareness by doing the CMEs and symposium. This will give you the authenticity and the your amongst the physician and doctor's colleague. The conference and our workshop should be organized on different levels. It can be small, state, international, and hands-off workshop. It is useful training. Then the training and teaching program, they are the very important things. Pain journals, articles should be published so that your branch is getting recognized, and you have to remain updated with the latest guidelines. Then the medical association, all the IMAs, private practice association, you have to take a very active part in all the functions so that you can represent your community as a pain physician, as a pain medicine over there. Then the pain care forum, with the help of all the NGOs and all these things, pharmacological manufacturers, there are many companies with the corporate and they are running like that, because every pharmaceutical company has a budget allocated for this. You can use that things. Then marketing among the general population. The media marketing, organizing charity camps, then charitable trust, hospital, pamphlet, brochures, public forum, exhibitions. So media marketing already told, charity camps you can organize with the places where you cannot practice, but you can go there in the remote areas, on the outskirts, and cover the larger of a population. Then the pamphlet on brochure, these are the very important things for this, especially who have started his practice, because it's a low budget marketing tools. Leaflet and pamphlets and customized brochures should be always published, and these handout should have a clear mention of all painful treatments, different modalities, conditions, and location and timing of your clinic and the consultants. It's a very important tool. And the public forum already told, closed group, and it has a common disease group like the fibromyalgia and all these things. But I'm just, there are two other sides. Then inside the pain clinic, you have to display window decals, the albums, display board in the clinic, and you have to LCD screen where you can give all the exercise schedule, precautions, and important pain medicine, and the documentation and file works. And the patient should be provided with the brochures, treatment outline, pain diaries, and all these things. These are all the marketing tools. And you can offer them offers, consultation, discounts, like that. And then the PRO is a very important thing, and you can cooperate your marketing team with other corporate hospitals in the chains. And the medical tourism is also a very important thing. These are all the type of monitoring. And how you monitor your marketing strategies, the success is monitored by the OPDs and the cost effectivity, and review at the time to time. In conclusion, marketing is a very important aspect to making any organization economically viable, and a lot of patients need pain management services. You have to reach them, and it requires a coordinated collective efforts. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Bhargav. We actually reached out to all the stakeholders. Stakeholders means the patients, the referral physicians, various modalities. Thank you so much for an extensive talk. I would invite you to my marketing team to give them a talk on the pain management. Thank you so much. Wonderful. I think we can ask him questions at the end of the session. Next speaker is Dr. Pankaj Surange. He doesn't require an introduction. He is presently the chairman for the Indian chapter of World Institute of Pain. And he runs Pain and Spine Center at Dwarka. And he's going to enlighten us on the use of ultrasound on musculoskeletal pain.
Good morning and good afternoon to all of you.
Good afternoon.
Okay. So actually this topic was given to Dr. Harshita, and because she had to leave, so I will be covering this topic. I just waited in last night only after having three beer. So just pardon me. So I'm not going to cover the ultrasound procedures here because we are just going to talk about ultrasound based pain practice. So we'll not go into details about how the bone looks and all those things. Okay. So normally as a pain physician, we know we are very much comfortable with this thing. See, yeah, fluoroscopy. Most of the procedures we can do under fluoroscopy, and those who are practicing since long, they are more comfortable with fluoroscope. Even if we have ultrasound with us, we are not comfortable. Like me, I am not very much comfortable with ultrasound as compared to fluoroscopy. But for fluoroscopy, you need a lot of facilities. You need an operation theater. You need a recovery rooms. So all this big setup is required for operation theater and for the fluoroscopy. And just compare with this fluoroscopy and suite and ultrasound suite. You can see here, just as office based. Your chamber, you can do interventions here. You just need an ultrasound machine there in your chamber. You can examine the patient, you can examine the patient there, you can do the interventions there. So, is there any difference? What is the difference? Why we want to go for the ultrasound? Can we make it an interactive also? Can we make it an interactive session also?
Yeah, sure. Go ahead. That will be very nice.
Yeah. So if you have any questions also, you can ask in between, because let's make it an interactive type of session. So these are basically every time we hear about all these things, advantages of ultrasound, disadvantages of fluoroscopy. But practical points I think will come if we start interacting with each other. So these are the various advantages of ultrasound, that it's more affordable as compared to fluoroscopy. It's not that machine is cheap, it's because the other setup which is required is less. You don't require anatomy of this thing, operation theater for that. You don't require a CM compatible table for that. So these are the various things where you can save money. It provides direct visualization of the various tissue structures, including the muscle, tendon, ligament, nerves, vessels, and bone surfaces. So if you compare with the fluoroscopy, in fluoroscopy what we see is only bones. So we have to go as per the landmarks, as per the bony landmarks. So bone is our friend in fluoroscopy. But here, the advantage is we can pinpoint anything with whatever you want. If you want to target a muscle, if you want to target a ligament attachment, if you want to target a nerve, perineural, whatever. If you want to target a cyst, if you want to target a correction in the joint, you can target anything as per our requirement. So that is the biggest advantage of using ultrasound as compared to fluoroscopy. It also allows the visualization of smaller peripheral nerves and their associated branches. Suppose you want to target a single nerve. The chances of success are very high if we see a nerve and we target our drug there. As compared to fluoroscopy, if you compare with the fluoroscope, we can, as I mentioned, we can just target the anatomy, the bone. Real-time ultrasound guidance on needle placement and medication intervention provide an advantage in ensuring accuracy. Okay, the another advantage, biggest advantage is that we can also direct our needle as per the pathology. So we know that very, very good example of this thing is your intra-articular injections or the aspiration, knee aspiration. We have seen a lot of times that if you can do it, most of the people are doing blindly. But we have started using fluoroscopy to be so that we don't touch the capsules. We can go directly into the joint space. So that is the advantage of fluoroscopy. But what is the advantage of ultrasound over this? And with ultrasound, with fluoroscopy or the band technique, what we have seen is that whenever we aspirate, there are some pockets inside the joint, and these pockets develop because of the adhesions. As the disease progresses, the inflammation causes some forms of adhesions, and the collection is there at various pockets. So whenever we aspirate under blind or fluoroscopy guided, we go into intra-articular and we aspirate whatever comes out, and then we leave it like this. But the advantage of ultrasound is that we can go and search for the pockets, different pockets, and we can guide our needle to that pocket and we can aspirate from there also. So this is another advantage of ultrasound over the fluoroscopy in the joint digestion or the aspiration. Another thing is, suppose if you want to go for the tendon injection, shoulder joint, subarticular, subacromial, bursa, you can see bursa. We can see actually the bursas here with the ultrasound, but whereas with the fluoroscopy we can see just a bony edema. Another, as I was mentioning, that suppose the ligament inflammation is there. So it's a dynamic thing. If we have a patient in front of us, we have ultrasound, we can search for the tenderness and then we can look for the pathology under ultrasound and then we can inject there. So that is another advantage, that we are doing a dynamic study along with the intervention. So before injecting, we can make sure that we are targeting our drug at the right place. That is another biggest advantage. What are the limitations of ultrasound? Limitations in muscle surgery is basically we can't see the deeper structures. Suppose if you have a myofascial pain syndrome in the deeper muscles, suppose it is a iliopsoas muscle, at times it becomes very difficult in obese patient to visualize these iliopsoas muscles. Then we have to rely on the bony landmarks. Suppose the structure is behind the bone. Behind the bone we can't see anything with the ultrasound. So that is another limitation. So deeper structures and bony structures, anything which is behind the bony structures, these are very difficult to visualize. So that is one of the limitation. And the technique is user dependent. So you have to have a good knowledge about the ultrasound, how to use the ultrasound. That is the most important thing. And the learning curve is very, very high. You need to know about the basics of the ultrasound, how to differentiate the different structures. That is again very important thing. You can see two lines, but whether it is a ligamental or it is a nerve, you have to differentiate. So these things will come with practice only, with the training only. And also it is user dependent, because now you are doing ultrasound also and you're putting a needle also. So your one hand is holding the probe and with the other hand you are using the needle. So you have to guide it. So this has, we have seen a lot of cases, even in the live workshop we have seen. People have started doing ultrasound guided intervention. They can show us the needle, but if you see on the skin, it was coming out of the skin. So this happens. So this, for this you need a good expertise in the ultrasound, how to use the ultrasound. Precautions, very important thing. So whenever we say the office-based practice, pain practice, that doesn't mean the patient comes to us and will inject and will say the patient goodbye, thank you very much. No, we are doing interventions, whether it is a fluoroscopy guided inside OT or in the office base, in the chamber. We have to take all the precautions. Sterile techniques, we have sterile probes cover. Sterile probes are available, sterile jellies are available. So we have to take all the sterile precautions. We have to go for the cleaning, dripping, as we do in the OT. If you are doing outside OT, that doesn't mean we will not follow the same procedure what we are following inside OT. Because these are interventions. We are doing some interventions. So we have to follow all the strict aseptic precautions. So these jellies are available. If you don't have this probe covers, sterile probe covers, at times it's difficult to get to those sterile probe covers, you can just use a condom. Just put a condom, use a condom, sterile condom, put a jelly inside, a sterile jelly, lignocaine jelly, you have jelly. So sterile jellies are again a big problem, ultrasound jellies. So you can use lignocaine jelly. Just take a fresh tube of the lignocaine jelly and put it over the patient. So that is also sterile. So you can do little bit of innovatives like this, but you must follow the sterile techniques. And also the emergency drugs.
We use the transparent dressings as well.
Yeah.
We use the transparent dressings.
Yeah, transparent dressing, yes.
We are using that.
Yeah.
That can be an alternative.
Absolutely. Condom is the most easily available and style also is disposable. So economical also. There are so many advantages of condom.
Gloves.
What?
Gloves.
Yeah, gloves you can use, but you'll have to cut at those things. Gloves are not that helpful. It's okay. But I think condom is the best. Industrial, whatever, transparent dressings, those are the best thing. Any other, if you have any other idea, you can come out with the idea.
What?
Oh, betadine. See, betadine, yes, betadine you can use. But the problem with the betadine is, whenever you are going inside, if you are going for the caudal, if you are going for the caudal block, so you are entering into the repetitive space. You don't want your betadine to go into the repetitive space. Okay, if you are using betadine and you are going through the betadine, your needle is all covered with the betadine. So you are entering with the betadine inside. No, transducer is not affected with betadine. Actually, you can clean with the betadine, but don't use spray for that. Never use spray. So best is just clean with the betadine, the probe of the thing. Just clean with the betadine and put a sterile cover into that. Put into the sterile cover. That is the best technique. And use a lignocaine jelly for your visualization instead of your this jelly, ultrasound jelly. Any other idea?
You can use spirit or scalenium.
No, spirit. No, not for the probe. Not for.
We have been using it for years.
No, not for the probe. I'm saying for
probe.
No probe, you should not use.
Cover.
Or the cover.
Once probe is cleaned with spirit or scalenium, then we apply sterile cover.
No, it's not recommended at all. Spirit is not supposed to be used. No, why do you want to use saline? Just clean it because you are covering with a sterile this thing, na? Why do you want to put out water or this thing?
Because to prevent air
leaking
in the interface.
No, for the jelly, na? Jelly is there. Put a jelly inside. Whatever cover is there, just put a jelly inside. Sterile jelly, lignocaine jelly. That will help. But spirit is definitely not recommended. Spirit or the sterilium. Definitely not recommended. These are very costly. These probes are very costly. 1.5 to 2 less are the probe cost. So don't use the spray. Okay, so another thing is, again, important thing is emergency drugs. Our emergency trolley should always be ready. So what are the common emergencies? The most common emergency which happens is, which intervention is? Vasovagal. So you have to have all the emergency drugs. And nobody can save you if something goes wrong. You cannot say that in the court of law ki this is just a minor procedure. So something happened, and if you don't have any facilities to resuscitate a patient, you are not supposed to do interventions in your OPD. You have to have resuscitation equipment in your OPD if you are doing OPD base. Because nobody can protect you from there. Because you are a doctor. You are supposed to save the patient if there is any emergency. Even nowadays the law is coming. This, what is called in that? This one law is coming.
Consumer.
Not consumer. This one law is coming, no? Where all the doctors are supposed to have their this clinical protection.